Every medication you've ever taken, every medical procedure, these devices that have changed our lives, all of these technological advances are based on discoveries that were first reported in scientific studies. Scientific studies have a massive impact on our lives, whether we realize it or not. But most people have no idea how these things come about. We just had a paper published in a professional scientific journal, so I thought this would be a good opportunity to pull back the curtain a little bit and show you how that process works. When you think you've made a significant scientific discovery in the lab or in the clinic, wherever you work, you write up your findings and you send them to a scientific journal. If the editors at the journal like your work, they're going to send it to other scientists anywhere in the world for an independent evaluation. That's the so-called peer review process. Some weeks later, you receive these anonymous reports, basically labeled reviewer one, reviewer two, etc., just shredding your work to pieces. Sometimes you can tell who they are. Now you have to go back and do more work to address the criticisms, and you have to put together an argument for why your stuff is good enough to get in. It's a whole dance, and there's a whole set of moves to it, and with practice, you get better at it, just like with anything else. My fastest paper took about a month or two from submission to publication, which is super fast. And the longest one took 10 years. Peer review is the key to scientific quality control. During the process, you want to strangle them. But yeah, it's super important. Peer review is what distinguishes studies from other sources. Popular books, blogs, YouTube videos. There's no peer review, there's no supervision, so people can say basically whatever they want. Peer review is kind of like Churchill's democracy. It's the worst system there is, except for all the others. After your paper is accepted, the journal publishes it, and people all over the world can read it. Future generations of scientists can refer back to it and build on it. So many decades from now, after we're all long gone, our work lives on.